Morning, ma'am. I hope you all are fine.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, firstly, you tell me one thing. Can you hear me properly, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
You tell me one thing. That have you got any notice of tomorrow's exam?
Ma'am, tomorrow exam.
Okay. Now let me tell you one thing. If you get any notice that tomorrow you have to give a class test, you may not get a notice. There may not be a class test. But if you get a notice, then the syllabus will be the science syllabus. The science syllabus will be chapter 2, adaptations. Okay.
Okay.
Only chapter and only short type.
And what exam?
Just class test as you have given previously. Just like that. 20 marks exam. 20 marks exam and 4 subjects. Syllabus is same, but for science, I'm telling you the syllabus is chapter 2, adaptations. Okay?
Ma'am, only chapter 2.
Only chapter 2. Only chapter 2 and only short type questions. I've told you before also. I've also told you before that. 5 marks for each subject, 5 questions for each subject, and total 20 marks of test. And the science syllabus is only chapter 2 adaptations, and only short types of questions will come. Only multiple choice questions will come.
MCQ.
Only MCQs.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Okay, students. So for this
what subject?
Science.
For science, only chapter 2. And if you get any notice, I'm again telling you, if you get any notice that tomorrow is test, only then. If you don't get any notice, then it's okay. No test will be there. But if you get any notice, then only chapter 2 MCQ type questions. Okay. And
okay, ma'am.
For students, today I will revise the chapter 2 from science, okay? Just for the exam, just for the test. So, now you open your science book, chapter 2.
Ma'am, when the exam will be open?
You will get the notice, okay? If you get the notice, only then the exam will happen. If you don't get the notice, that means no test is there.
Sir, other subjects.
Whenever the next test will happen, what I'm telling, whenever the next test will happen, the syllabus for your science will be chapter 2, adaptations. Okay? So five multiple choice questions will come.
And only science.
Only science.
Other subjects will also happen. Other subjects will also be there. Can you see the screen, students?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, only science. Ma'am, where?
Can you see the screen? Chapter 2, science?
No. Yeah, now it's okay.
Okay. So it was about habitat and adaptations, right?
Habitat and adaptation.
So animals are just like humans. So what is a habitat? Who can tell me? Any one student tell me what is? Okay, I'm muting you all. Who knows the answer? I will revise the chapter, and in the meantime, I will also ask some questions. Okay. I hope you all know the answers because we have already learned this chapter. So I will mute you all, and the students whom I will ask the answers, I will unmute them, or if you know the answer, you will raise your hand. Okay? Yeah. So chapter 2 in science is about habitat and adaptation. Different animals live in different places. So the places where the animals live, for what? They live in the places that provides all of its needs for survival. That includes food, water, shelter, and a place to raise its young. So that place is called a habitat. So all the different animals and plants also, they every living being needs a place to live. Different animals live in different places. So that place where an animal lives, that provides all of its needs, or provides needs for their survival, that are the food, water, shelter, or a place to raise its young, is called the habitat. Then we have learnt about different kinds of habitats of animals. What are the different habitats? Oceans and seas. You can see here the polar bears, the penguins, the seals, and the walrus. So here, this is the polar bear, these are the penguins, these are the seals, and these are the walrus. Oceans are the largest animal habitat on the earth. The fish and other creatures that live in shallow water, like coral reefs, are different from those that live in the cold and dark areas at the bottom of the sea. So the ocean, or the animals that live in the oceans or seas, are also different from each other. How they are different from each other? Prajakta, you have raised your hand. Prajakta?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, can ma'am. You tell me how the animals... Okay, do you want to tell me anything?
Yes, ma'am. Creatures means...
Creatures means animals. Animals are also called creatures. Okay.
Okay. And ma'am, shallow means?
The creatures, the fish and the other animals that live in shallow water. Shallow means the water that is on the above level. That is not that much of deep, that much of dark. Okay. That is not that much dark. And the water that is at the bottom of the sea, that is much dark, much darker and colder region than the water that is in the surface area or in the upper level of the sea. Okay.
Okay.
So now you tell me that how the animals that live in the oceans or seas are different from each other. The same that I have just told you. You tell me that again.
Ma'am, oceans and seas are different kinds of that. Oceans have deep water and seas have not that much deep. And then oceans, the sea has...
Not oceans or seas. I'm telling you the animals that live in the ocean, how they differ from each other. The animals that live in the oceans, how they differ from each other. How they are different from each other.
Because some animals have, they do not live in oceans, because that oceans is salty water. That's why some animals don't live there, and some animals is there because they have a moisture of.
Okay. You try to understand this. Oceans have two levels. The upper level and the lower level, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I clear? Two levels there. Two levels are there in the ocean. The upper level and the lower level. The upper level is close to the surface of the water. Surface means the upper surface. The upper surface of water. The upper level is close to the surface of the water. And the lower level is deeper level. Is the deeper level of the ocean. So the lower level is dark, right? And the upper level is not that much dark. some animals live in the upper level only. The animals that live in the upper level only, they generally do not live or cannot live in the lower level, which is darker and colder. The lower level is very cold. Why? Because light cannot reach there properly and the temperature is cold. So the lower, some animals live in the lower level only, which is cold and dark, and some animals live in the upper level of oceans only, okay, which is not that much of dark. So this is how the animals, the habitat of the animals, though the habitat is same like ocean, though their place of living is different, okay. The animals that live in the seas. Similarly, some animals can live only in the salty water. The animals that can live in the salty water, if you take them and place them in a water that is not salty, they will die. So that these are the importance of the importances of the habitats. Okay, because in some cases, if you take the animal from out of their habitat, out of their own habitat, and place them somewhere else, they will not survive. They will die. Here you can see in the picture, I'm just zooming this. This picture is of a... What is this? This is?
Dolphin.
No, this one where the hand... the hand is there or the spotlight is there. See? This is the picture of a...
Oh, this is whale.
And this is the picture of a... Dolphin.
Dolphin.
And then this is the picture of a... Shark. Water in lakes and rivers is fresh. This is not salty. So waters in oceans and seas are salty. And waters in rivers and lakes are fresh water. These are not salty water. The muddy beds of rivers and lakes make different habitats for all kinds of animals like fishes and shrimps. Okay, Jahid Mallik. Jahid, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes, ma'am. Jahid, you tell me that what are fresh waters and what are salty waters?
I cannot hear you properly. I'm again tell one time.
What do you mean by salty water and fresh water?
Salty water.
Salty, or where you can see salty water and where you can see fresh water?
Like oceans and seas and
oceans and seas have salty waters and fresh water.
Water.
Fresh waters.
Lakes, rivers.
Lakes and rivers have fresh waters. Yes. Srijit Parui. Srijit Parui, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now you tell me,
yes, ma'am,
that in lakes and rivers, that means in fresh water, which type of animals we can see? In fresh waters or in rivers or lakes, which type of animals we can see?
What can I tell?
Which type of animals live in? Just now I have told you, just now. Fishes and shrimps. Okay, shrimps, fishes, etc. These are the animals that we can see in fresh waters.
Yes, ma'am.
And now you tell me, Prajakta, you tell me, yes, that what are amphibians?
Some animals can live both on land and water. The land and water. This is called amphibian. Example is frog, salamander.
Yes, very good. So the animals that can live both in water and land are called the amphibians. Now, what are these were the habitats, the aquatic habitat. These were the aquatic habitat. That means the water. We have learned about the water animals, the animals that mainly live on the waters. Now, adaptation. What is adaptation? Who can tell me? Anushka, can you hear me?
Ma'am, can I tell?
No, you have just told me two or three answers. Now, Anushka, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, can you tell me what is adaptation?
Ma'am, what?
What is adaptation?
Ma'am, adaptation is the way in which an animal body's help to survive.
Or live in its environment.
Yeah, environment.
So the way that helps an animal to live in its environment is called the adaptations. Like birds have wings. Why birds have wings? Birds have wings. This is why they are able to fly, right? We don't have wings. We have our hands. This is why we are able to work hard. So the way we can work, birds cannot, right?
Yes.
This is why we have the hands and birds have the wings. This is why birds can fly, but we can't because we don't have the wings. So these are the adaptations. Okay. Just like the you have also learned about the skins, the scales of the scales present on the skin of the snakes, right? That helps them. Yes. That helps them to crawl, to glide on the floor, on the surface. Or the scales on the skin of fishes that help them to glide in the water, right? And so many different, the body coverings, and there are some animals have lungs and some animals have spiracles, right? Some have nostrils, some have spiracles. Who has spiracles? Tell me. Anushka, can you tell me who have spiracles?
Mom, spiracles.
Yes.
My man.
Okay, raise your hand. Who can tell me what are spiracles? Mannat and Jahid. Okay, first. Jahid, you tell me what are spiracles?
Insects have rare holes.
Spiracles? Are the holes present on the body of the insects through which they
breathe.
They breathe. They take in the air and they breathe out the air. Okay. That is called the spiracles. So spiracles are present in insects. And we have nostrils and plants have, what plants have, Jahid? Plants have stomata, right?
Stomata and photosynthesis.
Plants have stomata for gaseous exchange. So these are the adaptations that help us to survive in our environment. So now just let's check this. Body coverings. What are the adaptations we can see in body coverings? The outer coverings of animals, regardless of whether it is skin, fur, scales or feathers, serves as a means of physical protection against injury, changes in temperature, from morning to night and from one season to another. In this line, there is a question. The question is how body coverings help the animals. Who can give me the answer? Raise your hand. How body coverings help the animals? Only Prajakta and Jahid. No other student. Anyone else? Jahid and Prajakta is continuously giving answers. Anyone else? I have just told you, I have also showing you the line. You see it and tell me how body coverings of animals help them. Tirna Chatterjee, Tirna?
Yes, ma'am.
So tell me how body coverings help the animals. What is the importance of the presence of body coverings? read this section. I'm zooming this. And tell me, I have just told you. So what is the importance of body coverings? What is the importance of the presence of body coverings? Or the same answer will be there, how body coverings help animals.
Ma'am, the outer covering of animals help them and keeping them warm.
The body covering helps them?
Ma'am, every animal.
Here you can see the body covering, such as the coverings in the skin, fur, scales and feathers, serves as a means of physical protection. So the body coverings protects the animals physically against what? Or from injury and changes in the temperature. That means if there is too much cold in that region, if the region is too much cold, what happens? The body coverings help the animals to keep their body warm. Like in polar bears, they have thick white fur, right? And they also have what? They also have fat just under their skin. Remember, that fat helps them to keep their body warm. Okay, now let's see the next page. Here you can see that hair or fur, there is hair or fur, feathers for animals. Feathers also, how feathers help the birds? The only group of animals that have feathers as their body covering are the birds. Feathers help the birds to fly. They are very lightweight. They also protect the birds from the rain or the cold. You can see that due to the presence of the feathers, what happens? Birds do not get wet easily, right? If you pour water, and you don't need to pour water, if it rains, birds do not get wet easily. Why? Because of the presence of the fur. So they protect them from rain and they protect them from cold. It helps the birds to keep their body warm. The scales are there and the shells. Now tell me, what is camouflage? Srijan Acharya, can you tell me what is camouflage?
Ma'am, camouflage means a substance
Okay, Anushka, you can tell me what is camouflage?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then tell me what is camouflage?
The color and pattern of an animal often...
A little bit louder, Anushka, I can't hear you properly. A little bit louder.
The color and pattern of an animal often allows it to either blend in or stand out from its environment. This is called camouflage.
Okay, that is right. So the adaptation of an animal that allows them either to blend or stand out from its environment is called camouflage. Okay, Jahid, you raised your hand. You give me one example of camouflage.
Camouflage.
Example. Why camouflaging is required? Can you tell me why camouflaging is required? So now from the book, we can know that what is camouflage. So the adaptation that helps the animal to blend with their environment is camouflage. But do you know why camouflage is important? Why do animals need camouflaging? Okay, do you know what is predator and what is prey? Predator and prey. Prajakta, do you know what is predator and what is prey?
And what?
What is predator and what is prey?
What is predator? What is
prey?
That means.
Okay, I'm telling you. Now, students, listen to me very carefully. We all know that animals kill each other. Some animals are there which kill another animal and they eat the meat of another animals, right? Like lions, they kill deers and all other some other animals and eat them, right? So the animal that is killing an another animal is called the predator, okay? And the animal which is being killed or which is being chased by another animal is called the prey. If you are watching, suppose in TV you are watching that a lion is eating a deer, okay? Or a lion is chasing a deer. A lion is running after a deer, okay? The lion will be the predator and the deer will be the prey. Okay, understood now?
Yes, ma'am.
Just imagine yourself, a lion is running after a deer. The deer is running and the lion is chasing it. Why? Because the lion wants to kill the deer. It will kill it and it will eat its meat. So the lion that is chasing or that is running after the deer, lion is predator. And the deer is the deer will be called prey. Camouflage is very...
And the lion will be... Lion will be predator.
Lion will be predator and the deer will be prey. So the animal that is eating or that is chasing another animal is the predator. And the animal that is being eaten, the deer will be eaten by the animal. So this is why the deer will be prey. So this was predator and prey. Now where is camouflage here? Here is the importance of camouflage. You must have seen that when lions attack, they hide in the grasses, right?
Yes,
ma'am. They hide in the grasses and they gradually and very slowly go to the prey, go to its prey, right?
Yes, ma'am.
From the backside, the lion will very slowly, gradually come to the deer. And it will hide, it generally hides itself in the long, large grasses, right? And you must have seen in some areas, the body color of the lion is similar to the color of the grasses. Why this happens? Because the lion needs to hide itself in the grasses so that the deer cannot see that the lion is coming. If the deer can see that the lion is coming, what will happen? The deer will run away and the lion cannot catch the deer. So this is why the lion needs to hide itself somewhere in the environment so that its prey or the deer cannot identify that lion is coming and it will catch me. So the lion needs to hide itself. And here is the role of the camouflage. The camouflage helps the lion to hide into the environment. What is camouflage? The adaptation of blending the blending the body color of the animal with the environment. This is what happens with lion also. The body color of the lion blends or looks similar with the color of the grass. And this is why the deer cannot identify which one is the lion and which one is the grass. From a distance, it cannot identify that. So the lion hides itself into the grass. And this is the camouflage. When the body color of the animal blends with its environment and helps it to hide. Okay, this is why camouflage is important. Camouflage protects the animals. Camouflage protects the prey also. The same thing in the opposite also happens. As deer cannot identify the lions if they have the adaptation camouflage. Similarly, the predator sometimes also cannot identify the prey. So it helps all the animals to protect itself, okay, from any kind of danger. There is the importance of camouflage. Did you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So now the breathing organs. Breathing organs, I have already told you. Again, I'm telling you, breathing is the gaseous exchange. That means giving out oxygen, giving out carbon dioxide and taking in oxygen. This is called breathing. Different animals have different breathing organs. Frog and earthworm breathe through their moist skin. A frog may also breathe much like a human by taking air in through their nostrils down into their lungs. Birds, reptiles, and mammals also breathe through lungs. So we have lungs for breathing. Fishes, tadpoles, or baby frogs, oysters, prawns, and crabs breathe through the gills. Small microscopic animals breathe through their body surface like amoeba. Okay, now tell me, who raise your hand who knows the answer. What are microscopic animals? What are microscopic animals? It is written here that the microscopic animals like amoeba breathe through their body surface. But do you know what are microscopic animals? Who can tell me? Okay, Srijit Padui. Yes, Srijit. Do you know the answer? What are microscopic animals?
Amoeba.
If you know the answer, tell me.
Amoeba.
Yes?
Amoeba.
No, no, no. Jahid, do you know what are microscopic animals? Amoeba is an example of a microscopic animal. But what are microscopic animals?
I can tell you.
Yes?
The animals that we cannot see with naked eyes.
Yes, very good. Very good answer. The animals that we cannot see through our naked eyes. Through our eyes, we cannot see them. So how we can see them? We can see them under the microscopic lens. You know microscopes? You must have seen the pictures in your science book, the microscopes. So we can, the animals are so small by their length, they are so small that we cannot see those animals through our naked eyes. We can only see them under the microscope, under the lens of the microscope. When we zoom them, only then we can see that. So this is why these animals are called microscopic animals. The animals which can only be seen under the microscopic lens. Okay? So students, I'm again telling you that if you get any notice that tomorrow is test, only then there will be test, or else there will be no test. And if there is test tomorrow, if you get the notice, then yes, message will be sent from the school, and then the science syllabus will be chapter 2. Only short type of questions will come. Okay?
Okay, ma'am. Thank you all so much.
That's it for today. You just read this chapter properly for giving the test, and while you are giving the test, learn the process how to give online exams properly. Okay, every time you are sitting for the online test, learn the process properly. Okay, so bye students. Yes, Jahid, tell me.
The sound will be recorded.
Yes, that will be recorded. Okay, so bye students.